Welcome to video 10, volatility. There is a volatility index called the VIX. It's also called the fear index. The volatility index is for the S&P 500, which is an ETF. It's got the 500 biggest companies in it. The volatility index for the S&P 500 is a weighted measure of the implied volatility for several put and call options. The volatility index for the S&P 500 is a weighted measure of the implied volatility for several put and call options. They weigh time decay of the degree of being in or out of the money. So depending how much you're in or out of the money, that is what it measures. Now I do explain it a little bit in the next video as well, which is in Vega. Now there is a striking correlation between the volatility graph and the S&P 500. What you see here is, if you look at the S&P 500, is exactly opposite. The reason for that relationship is the traders. They become fearful when the stock falls or either when the stock rises. They became more complacent when the stock rises. You know, when the stock rises, they think, oh, well, everything is fine. I don't have to worry about so much. But when the stock falls, they are going to lose money if they're unlucky. So they are getting fearful. That is why it is called fear index. Volatility is a reference to the fluctuation level, speed and amount of movement expected at the market price of the stock price. So if it goes very quickly up or very quickly down, that is volatility. And volatility is unpredictable because it's done by people. So it's often chaotic. You know, the underlying price can fluctuate a lot, either to the upside or the downside. The market reacts out of mainly three reasons. The trading atmosphere is uncertain, it is unsure of the risk and has a fear of what can happen. Current events can influence the market so that stocks and options can either be overpriced or underpriced in the market. And then the market becomes volatile in the reaction to the event. Think about the trade war with China. The price went down suddenly 600 points. The market can handle bad news, but it is not very good in handling uncertainty. So, if the stock price falls, our option prices are more or less expensive either to buy or to sell. It is not so much the option which is volatile, but the stock is volatile, and therefore the price. The option can be affected by the stock's volatility, but you have to keep an eye on the delta. Rising volatility raises our option prices. Falling volatility lowers our option prices. And you remember, as delta measures the $1 option move given a $1 up in the underlying. Say that the delta is 25, that means that the movement of the option gets 25% of the underlying movement. It all relates to the underlying. So the volatility of the stock influences your option prices. If there's a lot of volatility, the stock, the long side, wants the high volatility. You buy, remember, low, and you sell back high. But when you have less volatility, the underlying, the short side, wants low volatility because you sell high and buy it back low. And they have a positive correlation together. But the key is the two sides of the contract. Who are you? Are you the buyer or the seller? Now the premiums connects the long side to the short side, as you well know, because the long side pays the premium to the seller. The short side wants to keep this premium and the buyer wants to exercise his right so he doesn't have to pay the premium to the short side so he can have a profit. So it really depends, who are you in that contract? Are you the buyer or are you the seller? Sell it high. So you want high volatility when you sell it because you get more premium. And when you buy it back, you want low volatility because you don't want to pay much. Now the second thing to know about volatility seems very contradictory to my previous statements. High volatility means for the seller who sells high and receives a premium, but wants to buy back low. And low volatility means that the buyer who buys low so to pay as little as possible to sell back high, that he can only do when the volatility is high. So then it suddenly switches on you. It depends, again, who you are in the contract. So you really have to keep in mind, if you're the seller, you want to sell high and buy back low. Now there is an average, and in everything in life there is basically you go back to the average. Everything has got a high and it got a low. And the third part is called then also the mean. The mean is the average of the volatility. So when you have been incredibly high, it will always go back to an average which it has had for years. So if the volatility is too high, it will tend to come down to the average, and it also tends to go up if the volatility is too low. It goes back to the mean, as we call it. It's a weird word, I know, but you know, I just say average, but you have to know the word mean. When the volatility is overpriced, then we like to sell, which is logic because you get more. But when, you know, you collect higher premiums, and when the volatility is low, you like to buy. But you always get more, because it's either overpriced or underpriced, you either get less or you get more. So you never get exactly what it is all about. So, you know, that is volatility. Just remember, it's the fear index, and at the moment it's at 20, we've had it at 8, but sometimes, you know, when the volatility is over 32 or over 20, and then you will hear on the news, well, the VIX index was high, the fear index was high. So that means that there's a lot of fear, there's a lot of uncertainty, and the market is not quite sure what he's going to do, which does influence your option trading. If the market is unsure what to do, you've got to start being careful. So if the VIX is high, think twice before you start trading and be very careful what you trade. Hope this helped. Have a good time, and I'll see you at Vega. Bye-bye.